Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for joining me here today. I was scrolling on my YouTube this morning and I noticed a video by Emmyology. She posts rat content on YouTube titled Top 10 Products to Avoid or Rat Products to Avoid, something like that. And it gave me the idea to make this video. So I started making notes for this video and I realized that it was really difficult to narrow down everything into just 10 things. So this list has 20 ferret products to avoid. Please watch this video all the way through. Find out how you can save money when getting ferrets. I think it's human nature to want to go out to the store and buy all the ferret stuff for our new ferrets. And actually most, if not all of those products are just a huge waste of money. They're all a money grab. They really know how to play the market, these companies. But anyways, a lot of these do not need to be purchased at all. And I'll be giving you alternatives to most of these on the list so that you can save money and actually improve the health of your ferret overall, because a lot of these things are actually dangerous. So let's just jump right into it. Do not forget to subscribe and hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, as well as follow me on Instagram for cute pictures of ferrets and updates. The first thing that I have on my list is ferret marketed kibbles. So this could be Marshall's, Zupreme, Missouri, Wild Harvest, KT, any of these brands. Pretty much any ferret marketed kibble, in all honesty, is just not appropriate for ferret consumption. And I've looked at ferret foods from all over the globe that are sold in stores, and none of it really stood out to me as being good quality and healthy. Actually, the only ones that did were marketed for cats instead. So I think you could say that most ferret marketed kibbles are just not appropriate, not species appropriate. All kibble isn't species appropriate, of course, but you know, as best as you can get it to be. And I've done an in-depth review, if you're interested, on Marshall's brand kibble, or the most popular food for ferrets, on my blog, if you're interested in learning more about byproducts, animal meals, and all that is found in most commercial pet foods, especially for ferrets. And many of these foods actually also contain carcinogenic ingredients, fillers, synthetic vitamins and minerals, grains, just all of these items that ferrets cannot digest or benefit from, the key word being benefit from. Number two, ferret shampoos and conditioners. This is a big one. Not only do ferrets not require bathing like whatsoever at all, period, most of these shampoos contain essential oils, which are very harmful for ferrets. They build up over time in their organs and create toxicity, which is extremely fatal in ferrets, and many have suffered because of essential oils and candles being used around or in their vicinity. A lot of these shampoos are just loaded in those products, those chemicals that ferrets cannot naturally synthesize like humans can. And you'll notice on my list, most of what I have is by Marshall's, and that's because they dominate the ferret market. You'll also notice that Marshall's is obsessed with odor control. They have odor control chews, water additives, sprays, shampoos, body rinses, all marketed to help minimize smell, which is very smart of them to do this, and it caters towards the parents that haven't really done their research before getting the ferrets, younger people who haven't done their research, and they look at these things and they're like, oh, you know, odor control, it's gonna make my ferret smell better. You know, why would this be harmful, right? For example, Marshall's has a tea tree oil shampoo, and that specifically tea tree oil is extremely, extremely toxic for ferrets, and I don't even know why this type of product is allowed to be sold. Some other examples that you might find, I have a list here. You've got 8-in-1 Ferret Sheen. This is also very popular. Marshall Baking Soda Ferret Shampoo, Fancy Ferret Coat Brightening Shampoo, Marshall Tropical Blend Ferret Cream Rinse. I think the cream rinses are meant to be used as conditioners along with shampoos. Marshall Tea Tree Ferret Spray, so that's like a body spritz, which we'll talk more about later. The list just goes on. And again, like I said, Marshall's is just extremely obsessed with making ferrets smell better, even though it's really just a band-aid. You're putting all of these, it's like with people, you know, you can lather yourself in with cologne and perfume, but if you're not healthy on the inside, it's not, you know, it's not going to do anything. Number three, I have salmon oil in a pump. So the thing with fish oils and salmon oil, which is what most ferret owners use for their ferrets, both raw fed and kibble fed, the thing with them is they are extremely prone to oxidation, meaning all of the healthy benefits from the oils just goes. It goes rancid very, very quickly once it hits oxygen. Many oils have actually already oxidized long before they hit your shelves. That's how easy it is for it to happen. That's how unstable the fish oil is. And when it's stored in a pump, it happens even more so. So it just speeds up the process of oxidation. And basically, you're just feeding your ferret just fat oil with, you know, really none of the benefits at all. So if you do want to feed salmon oil, aim for dark bottles with just a normal lid and use a dropper instead to administer it and store it in the fridge. All fish oils should be kept in the fridge or else, again, oxidation just gets even worse. Also, make sure that the brand of salmon oil that you choose contains vitamin E preservative. Now that sounds bad, you know, why do we want this vitamin E preservative? But actually it is required. It is absolutely necessary to keep the fats semi-intact. Without that, the oil becomes even more unstable than it already is. That being said, still stay away from oils that contain rosemary extract. Rosemary extract is not a healthy ingredient for pets, so stay away from any of them that says like salmon oil and then comma rosemary extract. You want to stay away from that. The salmon oil with vitamin E preservative is fine. It is safe for your ferrets. And I wanted to add in though that fish oil is not perfect. I think everyone, especially on social media, is putting salmon oil on such a high pedestal. It's like, you know, if you want your ferret to gain weight, if you want them to have a healthy coat, yada yada yada, feed salmon oil. And a lot of people do it too much, and that actually, you know, makes things a lot worse for their ferret. Their ferret will not be healthy if you're overfeeding salmon oil, and it's very easy to overfeed salmon oil. I have a whole article on it, on how to make sure that you're not overfeeding it. The cons versus the pros of salmon oil. I do not personally feed salmon oil. I actually don't really recommend it to people because just of the whole oxidation process and how most of the oils that we're feeding are long rancid and are not super healthy. Instead, I feed whole fish once or twice a week. Not only does it have the same omega fatty acid benefits, it actually has them in a greater quantity and a better quality. I feed things like mackerel, sardines, salmon, all of which are very, very healthy additions to a ferret diet. Of course, if you are feeding raw, if you are feeding kibble, feel free to incorporate freeze-dried fish items to your ferret's meals or just as treats. You can do freeze-dried salmon is a really, really good one, and I would recommend that. Number four, Marshall Health products like Ferret RX, the ear cleaner, all things. Don't waste your money on these things, okay? If you are providing proper housing, feeding a proper diet, and you are keeping your ferret with other ferrets, you shouldn't have a problem with keeping ears clean. I don't clean my ferret's ears. If I ever need to, I would just use a damp cotton ball and then just do the outside. You don't ever want to go into the inner part of the ear. If you have more than one ferret, they will also clean each other's ears. They'll do this when they're snuggling up. Please do not go overboard with the ear cleaning. It'll actually provide opposite results and make your ferret's ears extremely red and very irritated and itchy. Number five, a big one, we have Ferrovite, Ferritone, Tomlin Paste, Ferritvite, all the great vitamin supplemental pastes that I think almost all of us probably started out buying, myself included. Now I'm going to go down each of them and talk about what is wrong with all of them. So the first one, I have Ferrovite. Ferrovite contains malt syrup, cane molasses, which are very, very dangerous for ferrets. And these are suggested to feed as daily supplements, which is just not good. We have Ferritone, which contains canola oil, cod liver oil, which we'll talk about later. It's not a good product either. Ferritvite contains malt syrup, corn oil, molasses, all very dangerous for ferrets, of course. Tomlin paste, which you might have seen on YouTube or elsewhere, contains corn syrup, soybean oil, malt syrup, cane molasses, all very dangerous for ferrets as well. Do not buy any of these pastes for your ferret. I am begging you. It is full of carcinogenic ingredients, toxic ingredients for ferrets that will harm them and cause diet-related diseases such as insulinoma. On a balanced, healthy, and meat-based diet, ferrets do not need supplements. Do not waste your money on these products. They are harmful and they are unnecessary. Number six, I have Marshall Octopus brand toy. If you have this toy right now, throw it out ASAP. This toy is responsible for killing ferrets because the inner lining of it, the polyester lining, I guess, is very easily shredded. And ferrets have been able to shred holes in them, tears in them, and then get all caught up in the threading and dying. Unfortunately, this toy is not safe. Number 7, I have plastic cages. I talk about this one all the time on my channel because people are still doing it and people send me pictures of their ferrets and I see the cage in the background. I see the bars. I know that you have this cage, guys. You're not fooling me if you're not showing all of it in the picture that you send me. These cages are not appropriate for ferret use, and I would say most ferret cages that you can get in like big pet stores are not appropriate unless they sell the double ferret or critter nation. I still get messages to this day asking me what cages are suitable for ferrets, and I've said it a million times, you guys. The double ferret or critter nation are the only cages that I would consider suitable for ferrets. There are a couple others out there that are almost on the same sort of level, but I haven't personally used them, so I don't feel comfortable recommending them to you. These cages are notorious for being very cheap and flimsy. I don't know why people want to waste their money on a product that their ferret can escape from, that they can get stuck in and die from. Moving on, we have probably one of the most popular ferret treats, and that is the Marshall's Bandit Treats. I'm sure you've all seen them before. They have banana flavor, raisin flavor, bacon. These treats contain wheat flour, glycerin, propylene glycol, BHA, which is a carcinogen, natural peanut butter flavor, rosemary extract, and so on. Other flavors contain byproducts. Not only that, but they make it seem like things like peanut butter and raisins and bananas are healthy to feed ferrets, because I mean, it's like a treat and people don't look at the back and see that it's just like a artificial flavoring, which isn't good either. But they'll just see it and then they'll go, oh, you know, ferrets can eat raisins. I mean, if they couldn't eat raisins, why would it be made into a treat, right? It doesn't really click for a lot of people. A lot of people don't already have that initial understanding that grapes and raisins are poisonous and are toxic to a lot of our pets. A lot of people don't realize that ferrets are obligate carnivores. They rely on these big companies that specialize in ferrets to not give out harmful information, but sadly, that is not the case. A better alternative to bandit treats are just freeze-dried meat. So freeze-dried meat products. These treats only contain the one ingredient, salmon, shrimp, so on. These are healthy alternatives. This next product I'm definitely guilty of buying on several occasions in the beginning, and that is the ferret end bones. So these treats are marketed to help with plaque and tartar buildup on their teeth. These chews contain wheat gluten, cornstarch, vegetable glycerin, gelatin, corn gluten meal, rosemary extract, all obviously not healthy things for the ferret. Instead, brush your ferret's teeth with a small toothbrush and ferret-safe toothpaste, or even better, feed a species-appropriate raw diet with bones to help keep teeth clean. Number 10, we have the ferret bubble bag that you might have seen on Amazon or other ferret pages. I am not a huge fan of this bag, and it's because they tend to overheat very easily. And this I have heard from people who have actually purchased the bag and who actually use it. Also, just, I mean, by looking at the product, you can tell they do look super cute and fun. I just can't look past the fact that it looks like it could bake your ferret inside of it. If you do want to use this bag, or you already have it and you want to find out how to use it a little bit better, a little bit safer for your ferrets, and that would be to install a thermometer on the inside of the bag. But then again, you know, your ferret's in there, so you have to make sure that they can't get to it or that they won't eat it. Putting in covered ice packs, only bringing them out on cloudy, non-hot days. Direct sun could very easily cook your ferret on the inside of that bag. Instead of using the ferret bubble bag, I recommend using just a good old harness and leash. This also, you know, lets your ferret walk and have exercise, get them more stimulated. I know personally, if I were to put my ferrets in that backpack and take them outside, they would go absolutely nuts. They would hate it. They would want to get out so bad, and they'd probably claw their way out, in all honesty, because they like to be on the ground. They like to sniff and just explore, dig in things. I think that that is a better experience for a ferret. Number 11, the Marshall's water additive. I have seen this a lot, actually, both on YouTube and in real life. This stuff is gross. And people have actually said that it doesn't even work for them, so it's just another useless product, waste of money, don't even bother getting this. And I don't even want to think about, you know, the logistics of adding this to chemical to my ferret's water to make them smell better every single day for the rest of their lives. I mean, you have to be naive to think that that doesn't have harmful effects in the body over time. Water should just be water, untouched, with nothing added to it. Number 12, we have another Marshall's product, Marshall Ferret Lax. This stuff is nasty, let me tell you. And I swear, Marshall's will try to profit off of anything and everything. They have a product for any of your needs. Ferrets can get hairballs, but they can't cough it up like cats do. Sometimes if it's a big enough buildup of hair, they can't naturally pass it through and it causes a blockage, which can be very fatal and very, very painful for your ferret. People recommend to feed this ferret laxative to ensure that they don't get hairballs. Ferret Lax contains cod liver oil, malt extract, molasses, soybean oil, just not safe ingredients. I wanted to mention, because I said that I would, cod liver oil. With cod liver oil, it is very, very, and when I say very, I mean very, heavily concentrated with fat-soluble vitamins like vitamin A. And the issue with fat-soluble vitamins is they can't excrete the excess of those vitamins. So it just stores up in the body and over time can lead to toxicity, which again, fatal, very dangerous to the ferret. And so a lot of these Marshall products that you see in the store contain this cod liver oil, and a lot of these people are buying each product, the Ferret Lax, the Ferrotone or whatever, and feeding it every single day. So this is a lot of cod liver oil for such a little ferret. So I do not recommend feeding cod liver oil at all. A lot of just raw feeders in general don't recommend feeding cod liver oil just because it's so concentrated in these vitamins, and over time it can be bad. To prevent hairballs healthily in a raw fed or a kibble fed ferret, simply feed whole raw whisked eggs with the white and the yolk together once or twice a week per ferret. This will be more than enough for your ferret, and it also contains so many of the vitamins and minerals. Number 13, water bottles. I've talked about this before. So water bottles have been directly linked to tooth damage, tooth decay, and they don't give your ferret enough water that they need. It becomes more of like a game to them to try to get the water out. I think a lot of owners tend to be really lazy with the automatic feeders and the automatic waterers. They don't want to have to change things every day for their ferrets or their pets in general. Instead of using water bottles, use clip-on crocks or heavy ceramic dishes. That's what I do. I use a heavy ceramic bowl for their water and I put it on like a meal placemat thing. I do not fill it all up with water. I do a very shallow amount of water in there, and then I just change it whenever they need it every day. Number 14, we have Marshall's canned food. You don't really hear much about this one, but I do know of some people who feed this food. I believe it's probably the only ferret marketed wet food that's sold in big pet stores. There's some that you can get online from other brands, but this is really the only one that you might physically see in a store. The instructions say to use it as just a topper, not as an actual meal. But I think the people that I know who have fed this food or who are feeding this food feed it just on its own, which is not good. This food contains tapioca starch, pea protein, salt. I mean, this stuff is also dangerous and not healthy for your ferrets. Number 15, we're going back to the Marshall's Fresh Ferret Spritz, the odor remover spray that you spray actually on your ferret's body. I briefly touched on this earlier, but again, this stuff is not needed and actually harmful. A lot of them contain the essential oils. You might not see anything now, but later down the line, they have a very, very high chance if you're using essential oils or candles, room sprays, scented detergents. Number 16, we have Marshall Ferrovite and Ferret Lax Chews. So it wasn't enough to just have them in the bottle form. They had to make a treat out of them as well. So Ferret Lax Chews contain brewer's dried yeast, wheat flour, castor oil, rice protein, vegetable glycerin, dried cheese. Ferrovite Chews contain malt syrup, canola oil, cane molasses, wheat germ oil, cod liver oil, you know the drill. Number 17 is something that I didn't even know existed for ferrets, and that is salt licks. So on Amazon, you can actually purchase salt licks that are marketed for ferrets and other small animals, and these are, oh my gosh, please do not, whatever you do, do not feed these. These could be so, so fatal for your ferret. Ferrets are not natural water drinkers, so we have to be really cautious about making sure that they're getting an adequate water intake. And the salt licks just does the exact opposite. It completely dehydrates them. And I can imagine in a ferret, which, you know, they very easily imprint on foods that are salty, that are sugary. I'm sure that they would love that salt lick and probably lick at it until complete dehydration. So please completely avoid these. Number 18, mesh carriers. These are used very commonly with a lot of people. Some are fine for short trips, or if maybe your ferret's older, they don't scratch at the cage as much or the carrier as much. But mesh carriers and just mesh in general, your ferrets are at risk of getting their nail caught. It has happened to me several times in my old mesh carrier. They would get their nail stuck, like actually stuck, and they would start flailing around and freaking out until I had to pry them loose. It is not fun, trust me, you don't want that experience. It can be avoided by using hard plastic cat or dog carriers, and some of them are even big enough to keep a litter box in the back and actually tie up a hammock in the carrier as well. Number 19, clay litter, pine or cedar shavings. These aren't exactly marketed for ferrets, but a lot of people with ferrets still use them. Now with clay litter, when it becomes wet, it sort of forms like a cement and it can get stuck on their paws. It can get stuck because ferrets like to drag their butt after they go to the bathroom. If they do that with the clay, you know, particles on the ground, because it can also be messy, that loose kind of litter. If you have cats, you know what I'm talking about. Litter can just become cement in that area, and that can cause a lot of problems. So just stay away from clay litters completely. Cedar and pine shavings tend to contain essential oils, which we've talked about a lot in this video. I recommend paper pellets or pee pads or newspaper. I don't really like having a bunch of litter boxes in my apartment. I don't know, they're just, my ferrets don't really like to use them as much. They like to just back up into a corner with a pee pad or newspaper already there. My absolute favorite to use is newspaper above everything else. I don't know what it is, but newspaper just does a really, really good job of absorbing urine, and it looks a lot better in my opinion than actual, you know, white pee pads, because I mean, then you can see like all the poop and all the pee on it. With newspaper, it kind of blends in a little bit better. Our last item on this list is loose bedding, like Carefresh, anything like that meant for hamsters, other rodents. I used to buy this in the very beginning and I quickly regretted it. It's not ideal and it's also pretty pricey. This stuff just gets everywhere. It gets all over the floor. It can get stuck to their paws. It can get into their food, into their water. Very easily ingested by the ferret too. Instead, use fleece or baby blankets that you can wash weekly. Not only is it more environmentally friendly, but it's safer and it's also cozier. All right, so that is all that I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry about the lighting changes in this video. I'm using my webcam if you can't tell because my phone is acting up. Please do not forget to subscribe, you guys. I could really use it, especially during this crazy time right now. Do not hesitate to leave video suggestions, video ideas in the comment section. I really appreciate it. Sort of running out of content, but anyways, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.